Good morning, students. Hope you all having good time. In this pandemic situation, be safe and healthy. I am Dr. K. Vasu, Government Markazi High School. I am teaching bioscience for 10th class. Today we are going to discuss the nutrition, malnutritional diseases and vitamin deficiency diseases. First of all, I am going to ask some questions. Why do we need food? In the previous classes, we discussed, we learned about the nutrients, carbohydrates, proteins, fats. These all are essential for our health. These nutrients are essential to maintain the biological processes. That's why we take these nutrients. One more thing, why do you take balanced diet? Is it necessary? Yes. The balanced diet contains proper amount of carbohydrates, proteins, fats, vitamins, minerals, which are essential. That's already have been discussed in the previous classes. Now tell me, what happens if we do not take balanced diet? If we do not take balanced diet, we may face many problems like nutritional deficiency diseases. What is malnutrition? The food which we take that is lacking from nutrients in required amount is known as malnutrition. So generally, the people suffers from the different malnutritional effects. In the elders, we can control this thing, but in the children, it may affect the diseases. Think about the malnutritional causes. Generally, the people which are having the poor health and willingly in the starvation, generally in some festivals, they undergoes in the starvation. So the people may affects the malnutrition in their body, and the lack of awareness about the nutritional habits, so they don't take the which food is having the nutritional quantities and how to take them. So they don't know these effects. And one more thing, the socio-economical factor also the reason for malnutrition. We can see malnutrition in elders as well as in children. We can recover the deficiency of nutrition deficiency in elders by taking of nutritional foods, but in children, this lack of nutrients for continuous period may cause the severe health problems like some diseases. And the malnutritional deficiency in children is different types. One is protein malnutrition due to lack of proteins. You know, the proteins is the building of muscles in our body. And calorie malnutrition due to lack of carbohydrates and fats. These are essential for giving the energy. And third one, protein calorie malnutrition. This is due to lack of proteins and carbohydrates. In children, these malnutritional diseases are kwashiorkor and marasmus. And excess intake of nutrients also leads to one of the disease, that is obesity. First of all, we discuss about the kwashiorkor, how it appears in the children and what is the reason. The protein deficiency in children, due to the protein deficiency, the kwashiorkor disease appears in the body. Generally, the symptoms, body parts become swollen due to the accumulation of water in the intracellular spaces. So, deficiency of proteins, it leads to accumulation of excess water into intracellular spaces, and muscles will not grow properly, that is poor muscle development, and legs, hands, face will become swollen. See the figure. These children affected by the kwashiorkor, and skin becomes dry and always suffer with diarrhea. And another disease in children is marasmus. This is due to the deficiency of protein and calorie deficiency. That is, proteins and also energy giving substances like carbohydrates and fats. Generally, this disease appears in the children due to the immediate pregnancies of the mother. That means the age gap between two children is very less. So, here the symptoms are, the marasmus symptoms are like this: lean and weak, the less development of muscles and the joint pains, and dry skin continuously, and they affects by the diarrhea. Always they suffer from the diarrhea. So see the figure, the affected child of marasmus. So the bones will appear very clearly in this person. So not only a deficiency of nutrients, even excess intake of calories leads to obesity. Generally, the children, the up to 10 years age of children, generally the mothers will give the food material. Whenever they cry, they give the food to the children. So this excess intake, it leads to excess intake of calories. It's a generally they don't know the effects of these problem. It becomes the big health hazard. Due to this, children may suffer or targeted by many diseases in future, like diabetes, heart disease, digestive problems, and cardiovascular problems, renal, bladder problems. Just you think about the junk food. Children, you all are very fond of these junk food and somewhat the burgers, pizzas like that. So don't take that. These junk foods and your unhealthy food habits leads to obesity. Not only obesity, it may leads to the digestive problems. Once you think about these junk food and how to avoid this junk food. So, be careful while taking the outside food, that is junk food. Now, so these are the kwashiorkor, marasmus, obesity. These problems in the children, a deficiency of nutrients and excess of nutrients leads to these problems. Now, one more thing. I want to discuss. Generally, the nutrients are two types. One is macronutrients. Another one is micronutrients. What are the macronutrients? Carbohydrates, proteins, fats. These are the macronutrients. That means these are essential in large amount in the body. But micronutrients, they need us very small quantity and they are also essential to our body. Vitamins, minerals are the micronutrients. So here the importance of vitamins. What happens if we do not take these vitamin contents? Is any problem to our body? Let us discuss. The vitamins are organic substances and these are the micronutrients. Generally, vitamins are not synthesized in the body. We take by the food and sometimes and in some vitamins are synthesized in our intestine, that is by the bacteria. So here the vitamins are two types, water soluble and fat soluble. Water soluble vitamins, B complex and C vitamins are water soluble vitamins, and A, D, E, K are the fat soluble vitamins. Let us discuss in detail about the water soluble vitamins, that is B complex vitamins. First one, thiamine. Its scientific name is thiamine. It is called as B1. Generally, the resources are cereals, oil, seeds, vegetables, milk, meat, fish, and eggs. So, whenever we take these food items, automatically these B complex vitamins will get to our body. What happens if the deficiency of these vitamins? It leads to the beriberi disease. The symptoms of this disease is vomiting, fits, loss of appetite, difficulty in breathing, paralysis, and the paining in the legs. These are the symptoms. Now, one more vitamin, B complex vitamin, riboflavin. It's called as a B2. And the resources, milk, eggs, liver, kidney, green leafy vegetables. The deficiency of these vitamin leads to glossitis. See the figure here. The symptoms are mouth cracks at corners, red and sore tongue, photophobia, scaly skin. B3 vitamin, that is niacin. So this vitamin, if you take these food material, the resources, kidney, liver, meat, egg, fish, oil seeds are the resources. And these vitamin deficiency leads to pellagra. The symptoms of this pellagra, the skin is affected by these vitamins. That is dermatitis and diarrhea, loss of memory, scaly skin. The pellagra disease appears on the hands, the scalps like appear on the skin. One more B complex vitamin, that is B6. The scientific name of these B6 is rhodopsin. And the resources for these vitamin, cereals, oil seeds, vegetables, milk, meat, fish, egg, liver. The deficiency of these vitamin leads to anemia. The hemoglobin percentage will decrease. The symptoms, hyper irritability, nausea, vomiting, fits. generally, if the vitamin deficiency is there, then it leads to anemic patients. B12 vitamin. The scientific name of this vitamin is cyanocobalamin. Resources are synthesized by bacteria. Already we discussed that. The sources of vitamins are by the food or the bacteria which are present in our intestine prepares the vitamins. So, deficiency of this vitamin leads to pernicious anemia. It's more effective than normal anemia. And symptoms are lean and weak, less appetite. One more vitamin, folic acid. The resources of folic acid: liver, meat, egg, milk, fruits, cereals, leafy vegetables. And also, these vitamin deficiency leads to anemia. Symptoms of this disease: diarrhea, loss of leukocytes, problem related to mucus in the intestine. Pantothenic acid. The resources of pantothenic acid are sweet potatoes, groundnuts, liver, kidney, eggs, vegetables, and the deficiency of these vitamin, it is burning feet, the legs, which is the symptoms of burning, and walking problems and sprain. Biotin. The resources of this vitamin: pulses, nuts, vegetables, liver, milk, kidney. Deficiency of this vitamin leads to nerves disorder, and the symptoms for this one: fatigue, mental depression, and muscle pains. So, up to here, these are the B complex vitamins. Now, one more water soluble vitamin is C vitamin. Resources: greeny leafy vegetables, citrus fruits, and sprouts. The scientific name of the C vitamin is ascorbic acid. The deficiency of this vitamin leads to scurvy disease. See the figure here. Symptoms of this disease: delay in healing of wounds, fracture in bones, and the scurvy symptoms here, bleeding of blood in the mouth. Next, fat soluble vitamins. A, D, E, K are the fat soluble vitamins. A vitamin is retinol. Resources for this vitamin is leafy vegetables, carrot, tomato, pumpkin, papaya, mango, meat, fish, egg, liver, milk, cod liver oil, and shark liver oil. The deficiency of vitamin A leads to, generally we know that, eye problems, skin disease, and night blindness, those are the symptoms. Xerophthalmia, cornea failure. Due to the cornea failure, the blindness, the permanent blindness may appear, and scaly skin. So, children, be cautious about this vitamin A. Otherwise, you may get the spectacles also. So, try to take this vitamin. You know, the resources are very cheaply available resources are there. So, take these resources. D vitamin. The scientific name of D vitamin is calciferol. Resources are liver, egg, butter, cod liver oil, shark liver oil, sun rays. Stimulate the formation of vitamin D from the subcutaneous fat. Here, one interesting thing, How we get this D vitamin? Just you stand at the outside when the sun rays in the early morning, you stand outside. The sun rays fall on your skin, it prepares the vitamin D. And the deficiency of this vitamin leads to rickets. The symptoms are improper formation of bones, knock knees, swollen wrist, delayed denitions, and weak bones. So easily we can gain this vitamin by simply standing outside on the sunny day. Vitamin E, the scientific name of vitamin E is tocopherol. Resources are fruits, vegetables, sprouts, sunflower oil. Deficiency of this vitamin leads to fertility related disorders. And the symptoms are sterility in males and abortions in females. K vitamin, the scientific name of K vitamin is phylloquinone. Resources are greeny leafy vegetables, milk, meat, egg. It leads to the deficiency of K vitamin leads to problems related to blood clotting. That means whenever there is a wound, the continuously the blood flows from that wound. It takes more time to clot. So that is a loss of blood, no? So the K vitamin resources, if we take, generally the blood will clot very fastly. Symptoms, delay in blood clotting and over bleeding. So up to here we discussed about the malnutritional diseases and vitamin deficiency diseases. Children, here are some questions for you, and write in your notebook and try to find out the answers. What are the reasons for malnutrition and differences between kwashiorkor and marasmus? How to overcome the vitamin deficiency problems? Thank you, children. And this is the opportunity from Warangal Urban Education Department. Thank you. Thank you, one and all.